finally beat Medicare.
It was this debate performance in June that rang alarm bells for Democrats. In a weak, raspy voice, Joe Biden searched for his words and struggled to land a punch against Donald Trump, only aggravating concerns about his age. The president acknowledged his weak performance but sought to move forward.
I don't debate as well as I used to. But I know what I do know. I know how to tell the truth.
Days later, Lloyd Doggett became the first Democratic congressman to call for Biden to withdraw, prompting several more to follow. But it wasn't just party members turning on him. In an op-ed for the New York Times, celebrity Democratic donor George Clooney said Biden wasn't the same man he was in 2010 or even in 2020.
Let's finish this job. I know we can.
Crucially, major donors said they would pause funding until the president bowed out, including the heir to the Disney family fortune, Abigail Disney, and media tycoon, Barry Diller. Then, Biden's gaffes at the NATO summit in Washington further stoked anxieties. He referred to Kamala Harris as Vice President Trump and wrongly introduced Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky as his Russian counterpart.
Ladies and gentlemen, President Putin.
President Putin.
You can beat President Putin. President Zelensky.
A week ago, in the wake of the assassination attempt on Trump, the Biden campaign said it would pull down TV ads and pause communications. And on Wednesday, the 81-year-old tested positive for COVID, forcing him to cancel events and self-isolate. By Friday, about a dozen more Democratic lawmakers had joined the chorus demanding he step aside.